just an idea. I don't know where this idea came from. I can just tell you, it was when, every once in a while I have these moments, I call them. It came about when the class of 1959 had their class reunion, and they came in and they were talking to me about money that they had left over. And they wanted to donate that money to Franklin to do something good and something special. And I think we were having an athletic hall of fame at the time. And I came up, I remember talking to the committee and said, well, we can do a teacher hall of fame, you know, or something academic hall of fame. And so they donated their leftover money. And so this was a process that we started. It's been in the makings over a year. And to give you a little background, you didn't get to see it, but the reason we were set up here on this wall here, as you enter the building on my left, there's going to be a plaque, a big plaque with everybody's name. They had a right, but it's too small. So we had to send it back. Likewise, a veteran would be, I think it's the Wall of Fame that we're calling it. We debated on what to call it because this is just a small way of recognizing those who have come before us. And what we did, we had a committee of teachers here recommend former teachers and even staff members to come to be in, to receive this honor. Then we had another committee of people out there in JQ Public who kind of narrowed down the list and put them in order. You know, we said the first year we just want to make it special and only have about 10 people. They chose those 10 people. So really would not be blamed for, you know, choosing who went into the Wall of Fame. So again, I thank all of those people. And when we got this idea and we got money, I knew I had to give it to somebody. You know, so you know how you hand out things? So I handed this off to Mr. Sheets, our IB coordinator, and I'm going to introduce you to him, but I'm going to bring him up, and our IB students helped put this on tonight, so I thank you all of you.
Thank you for coming. It's our first time to do this, so we're all sort of feeling it out. I'm going to correct Ms. Nickerson on one thing. She said something a few months ago that was really clever, and I think she's already forgotten it. But we were calling this we started off with Hall of Fame, because like she said, it kind of built off the idea of what athletics was doing. Then we decided that we wanted to do a display, we started calling it Wall of Fame. But then at some point she said, you know, teachers don't do this to become famous, but we should honor them. And so we changed it from Hall of Fame to Hall of Honor. So we're going with Hall of Honor, I think, when we do the lettering. But as you said, the plaque that we ordered came, and it was about 18 inches, about 24 inches, and we sent it back. So we sent it back, and we requested one that's roughly the size of a really large movie poster. It's going to be pretty big when it comes back. And so hopefully when you come and visit the school next, hopefully sometime next week, it should be set out on one of these walls in the vestibule. And what we have is a series of name plaques for all of the faculty, administration, and staff over the years who were nominated to enter this. And hopefully we'll be adding to it each year. We're going to keep nomination forms in the front office. So if you think about it, other people in the community talk about it, they can come in and get a nomination form, and hopefully we'll be adding to this regularly. But we're thrilled to do the first 10 tonight. And as Mrs. Dixon said, we have a number of students who were really helpful with this. Thank you, faculty, IB students. We also did a lot of this through our school's History Honor Society. We're the only school in the county with a National History Honor Society. Something we felt was important to have at this school, given its place in the community and how long it's been a part of the community. So I'm just going to introduce a few people in the back. We have Bailey Lanai, who is our current president of the History Honor Society. Jack Brim, who is our vice president, will be president next year. Priscilla Kirkpatrick, who helped to manage the invitations that were sent out. Michaela Prince is behind them, and Hayes Taylor. So they were all very helpful with this. What we'd like to do at this time. time is recognize the 10 initial inductees of our Hall of Honor. And so we couldn't get everybody here tonight. We couldn't get representatives from every family. Some of the families we're going to be mailing plaques to later on after the ceremony. But for those who have somebody here representing them, we'd like to invite them up to the table. We're going to support Mrs. Dixon and I are going to trade places. She has stories about a lot of these people. But as you hear someone that you have ties to being called, please feel free to come up to the front. We'd like to get a picture of you receiving the plaque. And then after we do this, we have refreshments this evening. We would also like you to consider joining us at 6 p.m. in the school's auditorium. We're going to have our student honors night tonight, so we'll be going down and recognizing students who excel in each of the academic areas, athletics, the arts. But we would like to begin the evening by again recognizing these 10 former faculty and administrators in the evening. So we actually have a section of the auditorium that is set aside for reserved seating for you all. If you could join us there at 6, we'd like to again call these names and have you stand to be recognized as being contributors or family and great contributors for our school. We're going to begin tonight with Mary Trim Anderson. She was, I think, Miss Dalton championed her as she helped the class of 59 give the gift that helped to establish all of this. And Miss Anderson was an English teacher here and at other schools in the area in the late 50s and early 60s. But she remained an active part of the community well into her 90s, attending class reunions. She even published a book, The Restoration Government in the Franklin Area, which I hope the school can survive, was copyrighted in 1993, but it's still out there. And I just wanted to read a little bit of the letter that Mrs. Dalton wrote on her behalf. So it's just a snippet. First of all, she acknowledges Mrs. Anderson professionally, what her class was like. This is the part that got me. On a personal note, there are not words adequate enough to express what Mrs. Anderson meant to me in developing and molding my love for the study of our English language, literature, and even history. The love of our language and international literature that she instilled in me was the reason I made the decision to major in English in college and to pursue a career in education, teaching both English and psychology at the high school and college levels. So beyond the classroom, there was a life impact. And from the letters and the calls I got from the class of 59, that was not a unique occurrence. Ms. Anderson certainly seemed to have a wide reach. So we are very proud to have as the first member of Franklin High School's Hall of Honor, Mary Trim Anderson.
I coached his daughter
very closely. His wife, Ms. Ann here, is a former teacher here in the district, and Mr. Hardison was one that we all loved and cherished. And we're very thankful that you gave us Mr. Hardison. I'm very thankful for him too. The next nominee, I guess I've been in this district a long time. This is year 45, but I can remember the next nominee was the go-to person. He knew everything. I can remember the story I can tell being a young teacher. And we got these kids coming in, and those of you know who Northside is, it's Greenwood Village. But we had all these kids transferring into Williamson County from other parts of the country. They had already had Algebra 1, and I was teaching Algebra 1. So we had a go-to person here at what we call the high school. And that was, Franklin High was the high school. So we called the high school to find out what we needed to do, what subject did we need to do. And that go-to person was Mr. Nelson. So Mr. Bill Nelson's family, please come up, please. As we're coming up, I'd like to tell you something else about Mr. Nelson. Mr. Nelson was a science teacher here. He was the guru of chemistry. You could see him here in the morning before school started and after school started. Doing labs. Kids were dying to get in at 6 o'clock. How many people back then, kids came to school at 6 o'clock to get their labs done? And so, again, we thank you for giving us your father and sharing your father with us. Thank you. My time is going here, too, so I got to give her another. This next one falls into my generation of teaching. I had the honor of working here with him as an assistant principal here in this building. He was the art teacher here at Franklin High School. So come on up, Beasley. I can tell you many stories about Beasley. First of all, when he walked in the door, I told him, he looks the same. He ain't aged at all. I told you my body says I have. But Beasley was responsible for all of the beautiful murals that we had in our old building. In fact, when we built this new building, one of the biggest concerns was that we couldn't save those, you know, because people came and took pictures of them, but they had been there. And so Beasley, you have other family members here? Just you? Just you?
I have all of my dad.
Well, you got us.
I'm at that.
Yes, so he has us. So Beasley, we're very thankful for everything you do for Franklin. The next one is not here, I don't think so, but there of these 10, I was really shocked by the committee's choices because two of them called me. the next one is Bill Reynolds. So I don't see any of his family members, but we will be mailing this to Bill. Bill was a teacher here at Franklin. He came over in integration, and he taught wellness, and he was also a coach. So Bill, we thank his family for giving us Bill. Now, I'm very, very honored to give this next one. My story about this next one was, here it was back in 1972. If you know anything about Franklin, the Board of Education was a strip, maybe from that wall to maybe in there to that wall, I don't think so. But it was up on Columbia Avenue, and that was, it was part of the old Franklin High that did burn. And so that was the Board of Education. So I'm coming in trying to find a job, and the first person I meet was the supervisor, and that was Mr. Osborne. So Mr. Osborne, please come up and continue that story. But I think he made me the math teacher that I was, because I can remember as a young teacher, him coming up to my door, and first of all, you saw your supervisor coming to your door back then, you know, you were wondering, what did I do? Well, he had found some money to send us to a math conference. So he sent me to my very first National Mathematics Teacher Organization Conference that was held in Memphis, Tennessee. So I think we started something. Not only was he the supervisor for education, but he was also the vocational school supervisor over there too. So thank you, Mr. Bosner. Going alphabetically was Mr. Eugene Wade. And so Mr. Wade has any family here? Please come on up. Mr. Wade was special to a lot of us. He was very special to me in that he taught me. Ray says that he hired him back in the day. And so he was just a part of integration too. He taught at the old Black High School, and he also taught here at Franklin High. And you can see some of the things, traditions that have started here at Franklin High. When we do Hall of Fames or we do honors, we put them all together. We put both schools together because there were records up here, both schools were together. And so the committee couldn't go without recognizing the work that Mr. Wade had done. And some of you are nodding because you had, and you know plenty of stories of Mr. Wade. And you know probably better than I do. So, but again, we're thankful for Mr. Wade. And I last to come as a couple. Do we have any family members here from the Yates, Mr. and Mrs. Yates? Okay. I like to talk about Mrs. Yates. I really didn't know Mr. Yates that well, but I will tell you that I'll start with Mr. Yates. Mr. Yates was a CTE teacher. I think it was that. I might have got that wrong. But he was a CTE teacher. The former, we talked about Columbia State, but before it was Columbia State, it was Yates Vocational Center. So that was named after Mr. Yates. Mr. Yates taught here at Franklin High. He was principal. Then he went on to become superintendent of schools. So we are very proud of Mr. Yates. And yes, I come back to tell the story. Lauren is our assistant principal here, and she's a Google expert. She can, you know, we brag about she can Google everything. Well, in all of our annuals, Mr. Yates' name is just W.C. Yates. We wanted to know what the W was because we were researching trying to find family members. And all we could find is the Roadman School is named after Mr. Yates, because that's what the home kept coming up. And so we actually called this the Historical Society here to try to get what the W stood for so we could get a hold of his family. And Rick Warren was helping us out, and he finally told me that the Yates did have a son, and that he's in Florida or someplace, he's south, and then he comes back maybe once a year for his class reunion, but he was going to get a hold of him for us to honor his parents. And the last one, his wife, my personal story about Ms. Yates is that, think back in the time, during the time of integration, or it was still segregated a little bit, Ms. Yates allowed me to come to Franklin High School and do all my practical. I did all my practical for teaching math. Ms. Bosberg gave me, you know, my first job, but Ms. Yates gave me my first experience because she trusted me, a little girl going to college, to, you know, teach some of the lessons in her class. And so for that, I'm forever thankful. And that concludes our 10 this year, but we're very serious when we celebrate how we'd like for you to nominate additional teachers, because when you think about it, a lot of us, the committee, I think your original committee, they don't go back that far. I'm sorry, and Franklin High was established in 1910, and I think, you know, we have another set, the next rollout next year, and we have another that have been nominated to roll out, but next year we would like to be more than 10. So please nominate, take this serious and nominate teachers, and give us those stories, because, you know, you don't remember all those little tidbits. So,
please do nominate. We fought a very large fight. The gentleman in the trophy stop kept asking, are you sure you want it that large? Yes, we want it that large. I'm going to have to special order, which is why it's not here tonight. We're going to have a very large plaque. On the Ixmas Dictionary gave out, the school seal is at the top. And the school seal, the words across the top say nothing less than the best. Give me the modern challenge. And I think our students are very aware of the history of Franklin High School. They walk through the building, they see the graduation pictures, they hear the dates. This is the 110th graduating class, those sorts of things. They're very excited about it. They're also very aware that we are where we are as a school, as an institution, as a community, because of the people that served here, that taught here, that helped administrate here, those sorts of things over the years. So we're very appreciative. We'd like you guys to stick around. We have some refreshments for you. And I want to recognize Mrs. Rogers and Mrs. Street, who they put all that together. They were fantastic. And I believe we have gentlemen from the Franklin Home page who may want to speak to some of you and hear some stories and those sorts of things. So we've got a little bit of time to do that and to enjoy each other. And then in a little bit, we're going to try to nudge you down towards the auditorium because we'd like to recognize you all again. Thank you for being here with us.